Okay, so tell me about working on the set with all these fabulous big names.
Well, it's a pretty remarkable experience. I've managed to work with a lot of, you know, A-list talent over the years, but never a film that had this concentration of them all in one place at one time.
Yeah.
I said to Bruce the very first day I showed up on set, it's sort of like being called up from the minors to play with the Yankees. Everybody's an all-star. And you step out on the field and kind of think, wow, okay, I'm going to have to up my game to play with these people.
And did you ever, in your mind, picture Helen as an action woman?
No. There's always been a grit and an intensity to her, certainly from some of her Prime Suspect work in the English television series.
Yeah.
Solid, deep actor. So I knew she was capable of it, but it's something to behold to watch her firing an MP5 machine gun.
Yeah, it definitely is. You've got The Thing, too, right?
Yes. The prequel to The Thing comes out at the end of March.
Okay, it's a prequel. Why are they calling it The Thing?
I think they tossed around a number of ideas about how they could keep the name The Thing, which is obviously marketable because it ties into the other film, but have it be some other, like The Thing Arrival or The Thing Beginning, and nothing really stuck. So at this point in time, it's just called The Thing, and I hope that people recognize that that's an homage more than a ripoff, because this film is really solidly trying to be up to that standard of John Carpenter's film.
But I've heard that you actually don't have to have seen The Thing to get the prequel, to understand the story in the prequel, right?
You're absolutely right,
okay.
Yeah. Because this, if you are a fan of The Thing, you will see all the ways in which our film hints at details that are covered in Carpenter's movie.
Okay.
If you've never seen that film, this film will serve as a standalone that will be thoroughly entertaining on its own basis.